You know, I didn't think it would ever actually happen. So this here is the server browser engine repo, and this is the tagged releases. The very first tagged release has been made 0.0.1 October 2025. This release is the equivalent to nightly 2025.10.19 with some additional manual testing of the release artifacts. This, after all of this time, is the first tagged release of Servo. Now, if you don't understand why I care about this, I don't think you understand how long Servo has been around. And if you do know about Servo, you're probably just as confused that after all this time, it's actually been tagged. How? How, after all of these years, is it only at the first tagged release? So first up, I want to talk about some project history. Now, Servo's been around for a very long time. It is one of those early MPL projects. It's also an early project written in Rust. A very, very early Rust project. And like most of those early Rust projects, like most of those early MPL projects, this is a project that came out of Mozilla. And the project first began way back in 2012. First commit, February 9th, 2012, initial add. It is literally just a readme, the Servo Parallel Browser Project. And this is very shortly after in March, with some various stubs, some makefile stuff, and things like that. Now, any of you Rust enthusiasts understand exactly how early this is into Rust being a thing. This was peak Mozilla involvement in the Rust project. This is when Rust was still very much directly tied to Mozilla. It would live and die with the involvement of Mozilla. And not only the creation of the Rust language, Mozilla in many ways are the founders of the Rewrite It in Rust movement. The idea of, hey, we have a thing that already exists, let's take that thing and just make it in Rust. And for quite a long time, it did seem like Servo was going to be the thing that Mozilla hyper-focused on, the thing that was going to be the future of Firefox. So by 2014, Servo was passing the ACID 2 test. This is a test basically to ensure browser functionality. It's a test from 2005, so by no means like the most up-to-date functionality, and that was then replaced by ACID 3, and then things have kind of diverged in many ways. The ACID test was kind of very opinionated, so it's not really a thing anymore. But at least for simple websites, it was already a functional browser way back in 2014. And for some very niche, very edge case use cases, it was faster than Gecko, the engine being used in Firefox. Now, some of you may remember the Quantum project for Firefox from way back in 2016. This was like a big effort to make Firefox this more modern browser, bring in this new functionality, bring in this new UI and stuff like this. And that is when they began incorporating some of the functionality from Servo into mainline Gecko and thus into Firefox itself. And later on, Servo was also being used for AR browsers, for augmented reality browsers, like the Magic Leap in 2018, and then Firefox Reality in 2020. But 2020 was kind of the beginning for a major change for both Mozilla and the Servo project. This is when Mozilla did mass layoffs, firing about 25% of their workforce. And with that, almost the entirety of the Servo team. For those who were left around, they were likely moved into various other projects. So Servo at this point was basically dead. Mozilla didn't care about it. Mozilla wasn't developing it. They just said, you know what? We spent all this money on Servo. Who even cares anymore? But the project wasn't just being entirely abandoned. This is when management of the project moved over to the Linux Foundation Europe. So now it was entirely separated from Mozilla, but it still was not in a healthy state. It was basically on life support. It existed. There was some management. There was a bit of development. But all of that force that was behind it before was now just gone. This was during the Mitchell Baker era of Mozilla, when the company was really starting to spiral out of control, where I don't think anyone at Mozilla knew what they were doing, what they were trying to accomplish. And Mitchell Baker, along with other members of the executive team, were taking massive pay rises during the company just plummeting into the ground. They could have very easily kept the server team around, just, you know, take $1 million a year pay cut, and that wouldn't have even affected Mitchell Baker. It would have been fine, and it could have stayed being developed, but that was not going to happen. At the time, I honestly do think the corporate was trying to extract as much money as possible from Mozilla, just waiting for the ship to collapse. I don't think that right now they have the best of management. I don't really think they know what they're doing in the AI space right now, but they certainly seem to at least have a plan, which they didn't before. Now in 2021, the Eclipse Foundation launched Eclipse Onero, or Onero, I don't know how to say it. But basically, this is a foundation for vendor-neutral support amongst embedded and IoT devices. And with this support for OpenHarmony was developed into Servo. OpenHarmony is based on HarmonyOS, which is the operating system from Huawei. And as of July 2024, experimental server support was added. Now, the real revival of the project came in 2023, when this blog post was released, Servo to Advance in 2023. Things existed, things were being slowly developed, but there wasn't a real push for the project. This was that change. We would like to share some exciting news about the Servo project. This year, thanks to new external funding, a team of developers will be actively working on Servo. The first task is to reactivate the project and the community around it so we can attract new collaborators and sponsors for the project. The focus for 2023 is to improve the situation of the layout system in Servo. The initial goal of getting basic CSS2 layout working, given the renewed activity in the project, we will keep you posted with more updates throughout the year. Stay tuned. So this was with developers from Egalia taking on the role. And when we get to 2024, there was a talk at Fosdem. This is an article from It's Fos, but this is about the talk. And this was all about where the project was and where the project is going. And thanks to this renewed interest, thanks to this renewed funding, it is now actually possible for Servo to make any reasonable progress, because when it was just a couple of contributors here and there doing stuff in their spare time, you're not really going to build a browser engine. The way you make that happen is with really active development, with paid developers that can spend as much time as possible, and now Servo is actually becoming a thing that is very, very far from being a production-ready browser, but is becoming an actual browser engine. And this is basically why we hadn't seen a tagged release yet until October of 2025, because whilst the project had been around for a very long time, had been in development for a very long time, it was never actually at a point where it was considered stable enough to put a tag to it. That includes when it was at Mozilla. Back then, it was still a very experimental engine. Then the project died for, like, a couple of years, and only in the past maybe 2, 1.5 years has there been actual serious work being done on the Servo project to actually bring it to a point where they feel comfortable making a tag. It is still very far from production ready. It is still not a browser that I would install on just random people's systems who don't understand what Servo is. But it's gotten to a point now where they are comfortable to say, this is something that can be used. Now, of course, you can always just go and download the source code and just run that directly, but they have always had nightly builds, so if you wanted to grab that for any system supporter, whether that be Windows, macOS, Linux, Android, OpenHarmony, all of that is supported, all of that is a thing you can do, but a lot of people feel more comfortable running a tagged version, because generally a tagged version is going to have some level of testing to it and is going to be sort of expected to work to some extent. Whereas a nightly build, you can very easily get just busted nightly builds, and that's just the way it is. With this being the first tag, and with it being 0.01, this is still very early, but it is a step towards production, it is a step towards wider involvement from the community, and wider deployment of the software. And along with this release, they made a blog post about what is happening going forward. Today, the server team has released new versions of the servo shell binaries for all supported platforms tagged 0.01. These binaries are essentially the same nightly builds that were already available from the download page, with additional manual testing now tagging them explicitly as releases for future reference. We plan to publish such a tag release every month. For now, we are adopting a simple release process where we will use a recent nightly build and perform additional manual testing to identify issues and regressions before tagging and publishing the binaries. There are currently no plans to publish these on crates.io or platform-specific app stores. This is still considered to be very early, very experimental, and they don't want to do that wider deployment until it's considered to be more of a stable and ready state. Right now, if you want to go and use it, it is only going to be tagged on the GitHub. So even on the download page, you don't have the ability to download 0.01 here. This has the nightly. So if you want that tagged version, if you want to make sure you're using something which is going to get a little bit out of date and is going to be in this like weird position that is not ready for most people to be using, you have to know how GitHub works. You have to understand what you're actually looking at. Whilst we are still a very, very long way from having real competition for both Chromium or even just Firefox, I am really happy that we are actually seeing development on an alternative browser engine. Both Servo and Ladybird are a very, very welcome change in this space. I wish them both the best of luck, and from my understanding, Ladybird is further along, but I don't know how long that's gonna be the case. I don't know where Servo's going to be, but either way, I think there's plenty of room for at least two more browser engines. Maybe you could fit a couple more when the monopoly is literally two of them, and frankly just one of them, with the second one holding on because it's being funded by the first one. There's definitely room to make some improvements here. But what do you think? Are you excited for the future of browser engines? Do you hope that there is actually real competition that exists in this space? Or are you happy just with Google owning everything? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video, also go subscribe. And yeah, if you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Stelly Barapé, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and bring on the future. What's this?